All right, so this is an intro video for the titration that we're going to do on Monday. So you need to make sure there's a couple key things. First and foremost, you need to make sure that you bring closed-toed, I don't even know that's if you spell it, whatever, closed-toed shoes and a flash drive to, because you're going to make a titration curve. So when you go to make a titration curve, you're going to need a copy of it because part of what you do to turn it in the lab deals with actually having a printout or an image of the curve. All right. Your setup for the lab is going to look like this. A couple key things to review. The acid that you're going to be required to measure out in your lab is going to go in a beaker in the bottom. So I think it's 25 milliliters of a weak acid. It's actually going to be acetic acid, HC2H3O2. 25 milliliters of the acid is going to go in the beaker. It's going to be sitting on a magnetic stirrer. And you're going to have a laptop over here. Here's my drawing of a laptop. I know it's pretty fancy. You get the idea. The laptop's going to be connected to a pH probe. So the key thing is being able to use the software on the laptop in order to track all the data that you need, print it off or save it, and you're good to go. What else are you going to need? Well, you're also going to use sodium hydroxide. The burette, which is a volumetric dispensing device, you're going to take 0.1 molar NaOH, and you're going to fill the burette to right around zero. It doesn't exactly have to be zero. But right around zero, ideally, is the thing you want to start out with, so it makes it easier to read. So 0.1 or 0.10 molar NaOH is going to be filled in the burette. So you're going to fill the burette with NaOH, and then what you're going to do is you're going to titrate the acid with the base. So our equation is going to be OH minus. Whoops, that's not a minus. OH minus with HC2. H3O2, and that's going to be our titration equation. So, what are we going to do? Well, first thing that you're going to do is you're going to do this on a Mac, but it's going to look similar. When you set it up, you're going to open a program called Data Studio. So, if you notice the name of it right there as well is Data Studio, you're going to look for it on the Mac. A lot of times when you plug the probe in, if you plug the USB connector in first, plug the probe, it automatically opens to the screen. And then you're going to pick open activity. So when you go to use the computer, the first thing you're going to do is select open activity. The next screen you're going to see is you'll see on the desktop of your Mac, you'll see something called 15 Titration CF. That's the file you need to open for this lab that you're going to basically use. So you need to make sure that you find it. It will be sitting on the desktop on the Mac. You basically click on it, click open, and then what happens is it opens to a screen like this. In order to do the titration, it will track the volume that you're going to enter in. This is the data that you're going to enter in. You're going to actually physically enter in the data for the milliliters because the computer can't read the burette. And then what will happen is it'll take your data over time and create a nice titration curve for you on that screen. You can also view the current pH using the window down there. But ideally, at the end of it, this is the graphic that you're going to be responsible for having and writing up in your post lab questions and labeling. So, if we look right here, in order to start, there's a couple things that you need to pay attention to. The start button is right there. That's how you're going to start the experiment. I'll show you on the computer in just a second. The experiment button I'll show you on the other computer has different things where you can erase if you start, if you make a mistake, you can start over. And then as you go, if you notice the cursor, when you go to keep each value that you enter in, at that point, you're going to punch in the amount of the total cumulative volume. Because what's going to happen is that's what's on the X. The pH is tracked using the pH probe is going to be on the Y. And then you'll put together your titration curve. So, first thing that you're going to do is you have to select an indicator to use based on a calculation at the beginning of the lab. I'll pretty much tell you what indicator you're going to use. And you're going to start out with by prepping the acid, putting the acid in the beaker, setting up the beaker, turning on the pH meter, and then once you turn on the pH meter, put the indicator solution in, you're going to add 1 milliliter of sodium hydroxide each time. How are you going to do that? Using the burette. So each time in the burette, up to a certain point, you're going to add 1 milliliter. Then you're going to get to an area where you, once you leave the buffering zone, so each time you're going to record the pH, and I'm going to show you how to do that. You don't have to worry about recording the color. Each time after you record the pH, you're going to add another 1 milliliter, read the pH, keep going, add another 1 milliliter, you continue adding 1 milliliter each time. But then what happens is when the pH begins, the magic number is increases by more than 0.3 units. After you add a base, then you have to go to 0.2 milliliters of the base each time. So you go from adding 1 milliliter to 0.2. When is this going to happen? When you get outside the buffer region. The pKa for acetic acid is 4.74, which means if you add 1 or subtract 1, that's how you get the buffer region. So 3.74 all the way to 5.74 is the buffer region. So that means right when you get outside of a pH of 5.74, the pH is going to skyrocket. That's where you have to pay attention and only add 0.2 milliliters at a time until you get to the top of the pH curve. Because once you get past 5.74, if I draw a blank one, it's kind of like you're in this region right here of a weak acid titration. 5.74 is going to be right here. You're going to see a dramatic increase, and you want to make sure your curve has a nice slope to it. So once you get right out of the buffer region at 5.74, you have to only add 0.3 milliliters at a time. So pay attention to the pH meter as your group. You're going to add 1 milliliter of base each time until you get to pass a pH of 5.74. Then you're going to basically add 0.2 each time until you reach a portion of the curve, this area of the curve, where you get the curve start to flatten out. Once you start to flatten out, you can take it up to a pH of about 11.3, 11.4. You're going to keep adding base till you get to a pH of about 11.3, 11.4. You have a nice little tail at the end right here, a little yellow zone right there, and you're done with your titration. That's what your curve should look like if you're accurate and making sure you're following protocol. So you continue adding 0.2 milliliter increments, and then when the pH changes again under 0.3, which will be at the top of the curve, you can resume adding. So the last few additions will be back to 1 milliliter. So you really have to pay attention to the zone where you're only adding 0.2. Now, how do you use the software? Well, I have the software loaded on the computer right here. It's going to look pretty much the same on a Mac, only slight difference. So let's say I go to do the lab. I'm going to click Start. What do I notice? Well, when you click Start, one thing you notice is the Start button is changed to Keep now. So what you're going to be responsible for is each time the pH stabilizes and doesn't fluctuate by a tenth, is not really moving too much, you're going to click the Keep button. So I have this in water. So the pH of water is about 6.56 out of the tap. That's great. But notice how the pH isn't fluctuating down here on this little, on the pH meter, the 6.56 on the lower left-hand side. That's pretty stable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click Keep. What you're going to get is this dialog box. Each time, it's asking you the total amount of base that you've added. So you have to keep track on a little side sheet of paper. Each time, you're going to be adding 1 milliliter. Well, at this point, I haven't added any base. So the first value I'm going to punch into the table is going to be 0.0, and I'm going to click OK. And notice I have my blue pH value, which is sitting right on the y-axis. Then I'm going to add a little base to this sucker, like you are when you go to titrate it. So I'm going to take a little bit of base. I'll put a couple drops in. I don't have the spinner. This is just a little setup here. But I'm going to add a couple drops of base. And what you should see is you should see a change in the pH as I add a couple drops. And I don't have a stirrer, so I just stirred it. So I just manually stirred it. It'll fluctuate a little bit, 7.22. 7.15, it's going to stabilize. So wait for it to stabilize a little bit. It doesn't, the hundredths digit doesn't have to be perfectly stable. It's a natural fluctuation anyway. So it's kind of, it's not really changing too much. It's right around there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Keep. Oh, I'm going to hit Keep. There we go. So I'm going to click Keep. Now it's going to ask me what's the total amount of base that I've added. Well, at this point, you're doing your lab, you should have added 1 milliliter. So I'm going to punch in on the keypad on the Mac 1.00. And you're going to do that each time until you reach a pH of 5.74. I didn't start with an acid in the beaker. I just started with some tap water just to show you how to do it. That's the difference. So I click OK. Notice how it adds my other data point, and I'm good to go. Next step, like you would do in the burette, I would take some more sodium hydroxide. I add a little bit more base to my solution, and what's going to happen? The pH will rise. It's going to fluctuate a little bit, so give it about 10. It's easier for you guys because you'll have a spinner. You'll have a magnetic stirrer, which will basically mix it a little faster than this one's mixing. This is just sitting on my desk, so it's not mixing that well. So it's fairly, it's 8.9, fairly stabilized now. 9 is climbing a little bit. Give it another second. With the spin bars, yours will stabilize a lot easier. So for the most part, it's not changing too much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click keep again. Now, at this point, if it was you in the titration, you would have added another milliliter. Another milliliter past the original one. That's why you want to keep it on a sheet. Keep track of how much you're adding. So at this point, I'm going to add the total volume. Each time after you click keep, I'm going to add the total volume. So now I'm going to put 2.00. I'm going to click OK. And then boom. Now, I added too much. I didn't add a milliliter. I just poured some stuff in. But you can see right there, I have the pH recorded. And then basically what's going to happen is you're going to continue to add more base. So I add more base. I'm going to click keep. In this case, now I've added a total of 3 milliliters. So I'm going to add the cumulative amount of base that I've put in. I click OK. Boom. Now, the reason my graph, I'm not really measuring the volume. That's why my graph looks... Your graph should be a lot smoother if you're doing this correctly. And each time, you're just entering in the volume, the total volume that you've entered from the burette. Read it off. When you're done with the whole thing, you're going to click stop. When you click stop, you have your curve. Now, the next thing you're going to do is you're going to click on the display. You're going to make it larger. So I have my whole pH curve here that I'll have. I'm going to click display, export picture, and you're going to export the picture now on a Mac. It's going to export as a MIG file. You can't change it here. See, I can change it to a different one. So on the Mac, when you go to export it, you'll do this. You'll call it titration curve. Boom. And then what you do to change it is you'll open it on a Mac. If I look right here. If I open this on a Mac, I can save as, and what you'll do is, like here, same thing I'm kind of doing here, save. You can change it to a JPEG on a Mac, because the JPEG is going to be universally, so whatever computer you have it on, save it to the desktop, export the picture of your titration curve. You're going to save it to the desktop and just using the Mac software. Then when you open it back up, open the file back up, change the setting, the same thing here, save as, and then retitle it and save it as something else, and that's basically what you're going to take on your flash drive. And that's all you need to do to make a successful titration curve. Make sure you bring a flash drive. It makes it a lot easier. Make sure that you bring closed-toed shoes, and you guys have a great weekend. All right.